up, guys? It's Kyle from Newell Strength, located here in Hillsborough, New Jersey. My gym is just a block away or a stone's throw away from where I live, so I'm very fortunate about that. But for today, one of the things I wanted to go over with fat loss and food, I don't even like calling it nutrition or diet anymore, but food, is how one thing affects the next, okay, when we're dealing with this stuff. So that means it's not an information problem, as I've told you from mind mapping. You know what to eat, you know what's healthy, you know what's not healthy. All right, it's not a willpower issue. There's brain science behind why you go for the cookies or the bottle of booze or a few too many glasses of wine. You're getting a dopamine hit. It's going to get you more parasympathetic. It's going to get you what you want. If something's lacking in that anterior cingulate cortex, the brain always gets what it wants. But something I wanted to demonstrate today, right? So we took a mason jar, and let's say we fill it up pretty close to the top. And this is something I used to illustrate, you know, on the whiteboard back when Newell Strength, the facility first started. But so if this represents your nervous system, okay, and your allostatic load is how much stress we could handle before, and think of it as like a seesaw before we topple, right? So if this is everything in life, this is your finances, relationship stuff, things of that nature, where you know, they just kind of add up, these low grade things sometimes. You're changing jobs, changing environments, all this stuff. We have a finite capacity for our allostatic load, or how much stress we can handle. So if I can handle the to the top of this, that's cool. But when I get too sympathetic, so as this keeps filling up, okay, sympathetic nervous system overload, fight, flight, or freeze, we're going to get to a point where we don't have anything else to give, right? So what happens at that point is the whole physiology changes. So then it doesn't matter if you're dieting or doing whatnot. The cell structure, if you go back a few videos, will change, all right? And it literally is not what you eat, but it's who you are when you eat it. So for people that have type A personalities, or they're very driven and very, you know, much in their human brain, their prefrontal cortex, they have to be careful how to train and the approach they take to food. So with that, if I keep filling up, right, and I go all the way up to the point where it overflows, I'm topped out. There's nothing else that I can do at this point, except pouring it out would be, you know, taking some off of our plate, resting, recouping. We need to do that, okay? We need, not that you're gonna have no stress, but we need to do that so we can create room and we can let things function the way they're supposed to function. So if you use that visual and you're right at the tippy top, and you're doing a lot, you got a lot of stress in your life, and then you want to go crush a CrossFit workout or something like that, it's the worst thing you could do, okay? Again, the body is brilliant and knows what to do with its body composition, and knows when it's full and when it's hungry, when we allow it to do those things on its own, and we make sure that we're monitoring these other things, okay? And I'll give you an example personally with my own workout today, Wednesday. I did some yoga this morning. I'm going to ride my bike later. That's my workout. I'll stretch too. Tomorrow I'll get back in and start banging the weights a little bit, but it can't be all balls to the wall and grinding and doing these super fat loss workouts, and because, you know, using mind reality math, just think, how's that worked for you in the past? How's that working for everybody else? So just understand this stress concept and how we got to really monitor that if you're really trying to transform yourself. It's not as easy as I got to do this workout and eat this. Information is not the problem. If you have any questions, hit me up at Kyle at Newell Strength. Peace, guys.